Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to another Dassault Systems webinar. Today, we will discuss advanced realistic simulation for SolidWorks. My name is Howie Distel, and I'm the Simulia Brand Initiative Manager for Dassault Systems. It is my pleasure to be your host today as we discuss SolidWorks simulation and Simulia Advocate. Shortly, we will hear from John Waning, Product Manager of Simulia's Interactive Products Group, and Atul Gupta, Principal R&D Engineer at Medtronic, working in the Medtronic Endovascular Product Development Group. John has an MS in Theoretical and Applied Mechanics from the University of Illinois, and he has worked for Simulia in various roles, including advocacy technical support, customer training, and product management. John's presentation will address how you can move beyond SolidWorks simulations capabilities with Simulia Abacus. Atul has an MS in Structural Engineering Mechanics and Materials from the University of California at Berkeley. He is involved in computer modeling of stents, stent grafts, and delivery system components for design optimization and test method development. Atul's presentation will highlight the benefits of using Abacus in a research and development environment with a focus on endovascular medical devices. He will also cover use of the Simulia Abacus SolidWorks associative interface to transfer models between SolidWorks and Simulia Abacus. At this time, I would like to introduce you all to John Waning.
Thanks, Howie. It's my pleasure to talk to you today about analysis with Abacus, and especially in the context of moving beyond SolidWorks simulation. So next slide, please, Howie. SolidWorks simulation includes extensive capabilities. Probably the most notable of these capabilities is the really tight integration within the CAD environment of SolidWorks itself. It makes it very suitable for design validation in the early stages of the design process, and it also has an amount of scalability and makes it easy to use by design engineers. Next slide, please. But in some cases, customers do want more sophisticated simulations. For example, complex nonlinear problems, multi-physics problems where you're coupling several different types of physics together, for example, CFD and structural, impact and crush, which just have a lot of complexities that involve contact and deformation and material failure, among others, metal forming, material damage and failure itself, and advanced composites, as well as a number of other types of simulation activities. Typically, these are performed by analysts and methods developers with advanced skills. And if you can click ahead, the box shows all of the areas where Abacus FEA has a large number of capabilities and gives you a lot more horsepower when SolidWorks simulation doesn't quite have enough capability to do exactly what you want. Abacus FEA. Together, SolidWorks simulation and Abacus FEA can support the needs of non-expert as well as expert users across all FEA domains. And simulation can be leveraged in all phases of the product life cycles. So, for example, just looking at the bottom of the screen, you get a sense of where the different products, in some cases, might be very useful. In the early stages where you're working on research and some concepts, Abacus FEA might be used by researchers and PhDs at that stage. We might move into concept, preliminary design, and some early detailed design, and that's where SolidWorks simulation really shines, giving you very quick access for people who are most comfortable with doing design to also have capabilities to try out their designs with some types of simulation so they can test it out and further improve their designs and get into more and more detail. And as they add detail, get into validation, production, and service, that's where FEA with Abacus FEA provides a lot of value. So you can have a choice of either SolidWorks simulation or Abacus FEA in those stages, depending on exactly the requirements that you have. So now I'll introduce the Abacus FEA product suite. It's a powerful and complete solution for sophisticated engineering problems covering a vast spectrum of industrial applications. The core products are the ones shown here, Abacus CAE It's a dedicated, intuitive, and also highly customizable user interface for modeling, meshing, and visualization. Abacus Standard is the fundamental engine for Abacus analysis. It includes an implicit solver with extensive contact and nonlinear material options for static, dynamics, thermal, and multiphysics simulations. Abacus Explicit is another type of analysis engine. It's more focused on explicit dynamic FE product and modeling for brief transient events, such as impact or blast and forming. So anything that involves very high-speed dynamics or has very complicated contact may be a good candidate for this kind of analysis engine. And then finally, Abacus CFD is a computational fluid dynamics engine with extensive support for pre-processing and post-processing directly within that same Abacus CAE environment. So we have all of these Abacus FEA suite of products from Abacus CAE through the Abacus analysis engines, and you have access to these through the SolidWorks associative interface if you're a SolidWorks user. So let's talk a bit about this associative interface. It maintains a relationship between SolidWorks and Abacus CAE assemblies. It enables seamless, one-click, in fact, geometry transfer or update once you've set up the connection between the two products. And it eliminates rework as the geometry might change. And you can propagate those changes from SolidWorks directly into Abacus CAE with no loss of analysis features. So we're not talking about some import where you're just hoping things make it through and have to sew faces and do all kinds of cleanup on the tail end. It's a really seamless kind of integration between the two products, and it's really easy to work with. Next slide, please. So a few of the details about this associative interface. Some of the capabilities. It allows you to import parts and assemblies. You can also work with solids, surfaces, and wireframe geometry. So essentially, whatever you can build in SolidWorks, you can bring into Abacus CAE. You may have noticed on the previous slide that the picture looked very similar in Abacus CAE and SolidWorks because of the automatic transfer of part colors directly between the products, as well as suppress and resume state being consistent between the two products, and also part positioning and orientation. And when you make, I guess the most important part is if you make geometric changes within SolidWorks, you get those changes directly reflected in your Abacus CAE model. So it makes it very convenient to work in the two products simultaneously. After import, further changes made in SolidWorks, as I said, are propagated into CAE. And the other part of that is that when you have previously defined features for analysis that you've set up in Abacus CAE, such as, let's say, you've applied some loads and boundary conditions already, then you go and make some changes in the SolidWorks geometry. Well, you retain those loads and boundary conditions in CAE, even with the updated geometry modifications. The interface packaging, it requires separate SolidWorks associative interface license for Abacus CAE, but no special license is needed to install the plugin inside SolidWorks. So you simply install that SolidWorks plugin and then get the license for Abacus CAE if you're an Abacus CAE user already, and then you can be up and running in no time. Next slide, please. Okay, so now we've got a sense of the Abacus FEA product line, and I've talked a bit about the connection and why it's really interesting to consider SolidWorks together with Abacus CAE because of this associative interface. Now let me spend a bit more time giving you some background on just what can be done in Abacus FEA. We've got a very diversified industry presence. I have listed here 8 different industries which are very, very commonly used Abacus FEA analysis, from consumer goods through life sciences, which a tool we'll be talking to you more about in a few minutes, Aerospace and defense and automotive and transportation are some of the largest customer base that we have for Simulia, but also areas like high tech, such as drop tests or circuit board heating, industrial equipment, and architecture and process, petroleum, and power are also very well represented industries with that use Abacus FEA regularly. Into the next slide, please. So these are some of the customers that very commonly use Abacus FEA for realistic simulation needs. So you see we've got companies like GM, Exxon, Airbus, Canon, Johnson & Johnson. Just a broad swath of industries are using these products and on a very regular basis, making them part of their product life cycle. So now if we go to the next slide, I'll spend a bit more time just getting into some detail on just why you would use Abacus FEA for these various industrial applications. So in the area of life sciences, here's an example of pacemaker lead bending. And it's a pretty typical example within this type of an use case in life sciences. So here we have a pretty complicated structure. It doesn't look complicated like an airplane, but it's complicated in some other ways. You have these polymer sheaths and helical metal coils, and there's a great deal of deformation, nonlinear anisotropic material property, very complicated and constantly changing contact conditions between all these different components, and it requires some sophisticated hybrid element technology in order to handle all these different conditions simultaneously. So you can see there's quite a bit of complexity here, and it makes good use of the Abacus set of analysis features. Now, if you skip ahead a few clicks, you can see that this is an example of a pacemaker lead going through some tissue in the body, and we're trying to get some accurate indication of just how far this can bend and still not be damaged in any way and still do its function successfully. So if you skip ahead a little more, we'll get a sense of what companies are using this kind of technology. So these are some of the Abacus customers like Becton Dickinson BD, Johnson & Johnson, Baxter, Medtronic, and Boston Scientific are all represented in this area. On to consumer goods. Now here's an example of a bicycle model that's being simulated to see how it withstands impact. So here we have a composite bicycle frame, which has its own set of complexity already associated with it. As the bicycle goes over some bumps, we have nonlinear impact. And because of the way that the components are modeled, we have a number of different element types, such as shells and connector elements. This is an example of some of the, just the tip of the iceberg of what you can do in Abacus FEA when considering composite analysis. Abacus CAE has some of the best and most convenient, easy-to-use capabilities for setting up composite layups. As shown here, you can very easily view the thickness and ply orientations of all the different layers in your layup. And there are also a large number of capabilities such as failure and fatigue and all these other kinds of things that you can do with a model such as this set up in Abacus. So companies considering this kind of consumer goods simulation are Kimberly-Clark, Adidas, and DuPont. So we'll go to the next slide and consider the next industry.